Hi, this is Robert Rivas. Be sure and join me each and every Sunday evening for my Double R Radio Cruising Classic Show from 7 to 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. It's as simple as going to RobertRivasRadio.com, RobertRivasRadio.com, and I'll say it one more time, RobertRivasRadio.com, and click on that media player button. It's all free. We'll see you on Cruising Classic Sunday on Double R Radio.
Let's go to the year 1973, and I definitely want to talk to you about this one. The album, Deliver the Word. Now, on this album, Lonnie, on this album, there is a song. There is a song, and I got to give you a quick input about this song before, you know, we talk about this. There is a song off the Deliver the Word album. Easy for me to say, right? Anyway.
I can't remember everything.
There is a song that I was a kid. I was 13 years old, and my brother would always take me cruising with him. And he tells me, I want you to take a listen to this song. Tell me if you like it. And I go, well, who is it? He goes, just take a listen to it. Well, he told me who it is. He told me it's War. Okay. I listened to it, and I told him, this is simply awesome. Lonnie, I'm talking about the song H2 Overture.
Oh, the Oscar.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, that was, I think that's the one. I can't remember now. We've done more album cuts than we've done singles. You know that? Every song on every album that we only maybe use two songs as a single was some of our best, I believe, some of our best masterpiece in the painting, where you put it, make for an example for Deliver the Word. Every song around Deliver the Word, for me, were masterpieces with like a drawing or a painting. You could see those songs around Deliver the Word as the background, you know, in a painting. And for me, they were masterpieces, but I didn't call it masterpieces at the time. I just said, I like those songs, you know, better than the single, you know.
You're a simple man.
Just like I am now. And, and actually, Deliver the Word, you know, where we created that album, we were up at Caribou Ranch, you know, the group Chicago. Their manager owned this ranch up in right up above Boulder, Colorado, and it was called Caribou Ranch. And a lot of musicians would go up there, stay for about a month, and it was up high, really up high. But you had to stay there. You can't just keep coming down the hill unless you went to Boulder, and that took about maybe 30 to 45 minutes depending on the weather. So sometimes you get snowed in and you can't go down anywhere. So you're up there with the bears and you know, the every environment that you could think of. So, and you're up high in the sky too, so you can definitely see some UFOs. So, and that depends on what you're smoking. But we had the opportunity to, off the fly. And that's where Deliver the Word was created. I was in the studio. I just said, okay, I'm going to go in the studio early. Me and the engineer, we always went in the studio early because he was there always preparing, setting up, doing the preps. And while he was doing that, he would always run a tape that was on the side, you know, just a regular reel-to-reel tape so we can keep our ideas. And so I just so happened to just playing the piano again and singing songs like I did with most of the songs that I sang, like Summer and Don't Let No One Get You Down. You know, everything was already, I would always just play on the piano. I would have an idea at home, then I finally bring it to the studio and just run the tape. Then we take it from there.